planet is facing many serious environmental problems. These problems include global warming, loss of biodiversity, tropical deforestation, ocean plastic waste, and water and air pollution. Let's look at global warming. Earth's average surface temperature is about 14 degrees Celsius. This is maintained by Earth's greenhouse gases, which trap heat in the atmosphere and warm the planet. However, as human industrial activity has increased, large amounts of greenhouse gases have been emitted and more heat has been absorbed. As a result, global temperatures have risen sharply since around 1850, when the Industrial Revolution began. Climate fluctuations happen even under natural conditions, but contemporary temperature rise has been well beyond the natural fluctuations. This is called global warming. Various changes in climate, such as an increase in extreme weather events and heavy rainfall, have also been observed around the world. For this reason, the term climate change is preferably used, particularly among scientists, although global warming is often used interchangeably with climate change. During the Paris Agreement in 2015, countries around the world agreed to pursue efforts to limit the temperature increase to 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels by 2100. However, as of 2020, global temperatures have already risen by 1.1 degrees Celsius, and we are thus only 0.4 degrees away from this target. According to recent studies, an average temperature increase of 4.4 degrees Celsius is projected to occur by 2100 if the society continues with high economic development. To reduce the temperature rise to below 1.5 degrees Celsius, we will need to take immediate and drastic measures against climate change. Global warming is affecting the life of many creatures on Earth. A wide variety of living creatures inhabit Earth, and each fulfills an important role in sustaining the life of others. For example, plants produce oxygen, enabling humans and animals to live. Bees carry pollen, which allows crops to bear fruit. Biodiversity refers to the rich variety of life on Earth, which is interacting with each other. There are three levels of biodiversity: genetic, species, and ecosystem diversity. Currently, we are losing the species biodiversity at a very fast rate. More than 40,000 species are already extinct or threatened with extinction. The rate at which species are going extinct far exceeds the rate of naturally occurring extinctions. It is currently happening at the fastest rate in millions of years and is therefore often called the sixth major extinction period in Earth's history. The main causes include overhunting and poaching, habitat loss due to deforestation and land development, global warming, invasive species, and water and air pollution. It can also cause the loss of benefits we receive from nature, which are called ecosystem services. Humans benefit from nature in various ways, such as silk and cotton for clothing, wood to construct buildings, and plants to make medicines. When biodiversity declines, ecosystem services also decline, which has a significant impact on our life. Under the water, the plastic waste is increasing and affecting the marine ecosystem. From toy packaging to car dashboards, plastics are used everywhere, many of which end up as waste and accumulate in the ocean, causing a significant impact on marine animals. Entanglement or plastic ingestion has been documented for more than 900 marine species. Plastic ingestion has been found in 56% of marine mammal, 44% of seabird, 100% of sea turtle, and 70% of fish species. Global plastic production was 2 million tons in the 1950s, but it reached 440 million tons in 2017 and is expected to continue rising. The amount flowing into the oceans is also predicted to increase from 11 million tons annually today to 29 million tons annually in 2040. If this trend continues, there may be more plastic waste in the ocean than fish before 2050. On land, deforestation has been accelerating biodiversity loss. It is estimated that forest areas totaled 6 to 7 billion hectares before humans began agriculture. Today, only about 4 billion hectares remain. Causes of this decline include excessive logging, conversion to agricultural land, and forest fires. In 2020, 4.2 million hectares of tropical primary forest were lost. Most of the harvested timber is consumed by developed and emerging countries, including Japan, and it is crucial that measures are taken by these countries to protect the tropical forests that remain. As the global population grows, water consumption has been increasing year by year. Water pollution from industrial and domestic wastewater is increasing too, threatening the global water supply. 1 in 4 people in the world have no access to safe drinking water, and about half of the population has sanitation problems. More than 700 children under 5 years old die from diarrhea every day due to unsafe water, inadequate sanitation, and poor hygiene. Burning of fossil fuels, such as coal, emit not only the greenhouse gases, but also various air pollutants. Air pollution is one of the 3 leading causes of global mortality, with approximately 7 million deaths each year due to outdoor and indoor air pollution. Concentrations of PM2.5, one of the most harmful air pollutants, are particularly high in Asia, Africa, and the Middle East, where industrial development is booming. Some environmental issues are approaching the limits of the Earth. The Earth is reaching dangerous limits in material cycles such as phosphorus and nitrogen and the loss of genetic biodiversity. Nature has the ability to adapt to some changes in the environment, but there are limits to this. When such limits are exceeded, they cannot be restored and may lead to unforeseen and permanent changes. Environmental problems that are close to their limits or tipping points require particular attention and measures. Looking at the various indicators of environmental problems, they all seem to follow a similar curve as is shown here. Similarly, indicators of the state of human development, such as population growth, GDP, electricity supply, water use, transportation and communications, and international travel have increased drastically since about the 1950s. Some scientists suggest that we have entered a new era, the Anthropocene, as society and nature are changing in a way we have never seen in the Holocene. Can't we do anything to stop this rapid change? Recent studies show that it is still possible to reduce and reverse the burden on nature and move towards a sustainable future if the global society acts together and implement appropriate measures. The Anthropocene can also become an era where humanity overcomes the environmental problems.